he's got his revolver. But we're going to show you how he uses his switch with these characters that he used to do, because Euphoria is a very cool thing. He's going to grab this guy, he's going to throw him against the car, and it's never the same thing twice. That time, instead of falling over, the character actually caught his balance and came back after him. This time he's going to really push him, he's going to fall over. Now he's going to pick himself up again and do it again. He's going to push him over a different way this time. Oh, use your whip. That's going to be so cool. So it's different every single time, you know, when someone's laid out. Very cool. He's protecting his face. If he grabs him, he's trying to keep his feet, you know, he's trying to keep his balance. That is not driven by animation, that is behavioral AI. It's what that's called. It's different every single time. This is one of many behaviors that we'll feature on. There's also a behavior called a 2-is-1 behavior, where these guys will try and gang up on Indy and work together in order to take it down. Okay. I wanted to get him out of this and show him the other thing. The other thing I wanted to show you is digital molecular matter, or DMM. What Adam's going to do is he's going to grab one of these thugs and he's going to throw him against this door here. But as you look at this door, notice it splinters like wood, it cracks like wood, it bends like wood. This is digital molecular matter. That means that on a molecular level, the game knows what it is. It's plywood. It's behaving like plywood is. This is one of many different surfaces that we're promising for this game. This is just a sneak peek that we're showing you with this door. But you can let your imagination run wild. There's metal, cloth, glass, water. You could put a 50-foot jello mold in the middle of the street and throw a guy into it and watch it go boom, boom, boom. I mean, it would recognize them. That's the power of DMM technology. So you put DMM and Euphoria together, and you're making a game that is completely emergent on a fundamental level. You don't know what's going to happen. And to be clear about this, I don't know what's going to happen, and I'm on the team. The team doesn't know what's going to happen. We check something into a level, and then we go, hey, let's gather around the TV and see what it does. And then we boot and holler because we're seeing it for the first time and for the last time. If I wanted to show you the same thing twice, I couldn't. You know, it's always different. Oh, this is a fireworks outside a fireworks factory. I did that. And so these sets are spring-loaded for destruction. This means that, these characters are constantly fighting for their life. For example, this guy just is hanging on for dear life. That is not an animation, that is a behavior. The character is sentient enough to recognize that he is falling, and he grabs onto whatever is available to him at the time. That is not animation. That is not something framed cleverly with animation. That is a behavioral AI, different every single time you do it. Very cool. Wow. And then they'll trip and fall over each other, too. Nice. Little John Woo slow-mo for you. You can see the payoff. So this is the paper car chase sequence. Just like Raiders had the truck chase sequence, and Temple of Doom had the mine car, you know. Are the next to be classic vehicle chasing, right? And what the first thing I want to point out is that this is not on rails at all. Total simulation. Trucks are being driven by artificial intelligence. It's not a foregone conclusion at all. You don't know what's going to happen. Amy's fighting with this guy, and they just this guy's hanging on for dear life. Again, not an animation. That is a behavioral AI. Right there, just like that. That's great. Oh! That was great. Oh, there's still one in the background. That was great. Very cool. So George Lucas has gone on record. George Lucas has gone on record to say there's no character better suited for a video game than Indiana Jones. We agree, and we're pursuing that 300%. We have brand new technology, an incredible story, and it's all exclusive to LucasArts. All of it. The technology is all exclusive to LucasArts here, and you're seeing it for the first time here at E3. This comes out in the summer of 2007, so keep in mind, we still have over a year's worth of development time on this title, and we're going to use it to explore